rain in the area, but we've been given the go-ahead to get this one started.
Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Milwaukee Brewers and the New York Mets. It's going to be a premier pitching matchup. Two of the league's hardest throwers go head-to-head next. Now at the plate is Colton Wong. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 1-1 home.
Two ball, one strike.
Well, the key for him on the mound is to keep the ball down. Certainly, hollow of the knee or lower. Sinker changeup guy, if he's going to succeed against this lineup, he's got to keep the ball down.
2-2 count, here it comes. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game. Stepping in next, Willy Adames. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. And a swing and a miss as that looked like self-defense there. It's 2-2.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there. That's as good as it gets, in my opinion. Woo! Up and in.
And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
The left wing.
Lifted in the air to straightaway center. Giving chase is Nimmo. He can't get there as it falls in.
That is cool. The right fielder, Abisail.
Standing in now,
Abisail Garcia.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Conforto gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. So stepping in is Jonathan Villar. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 3-2 pitch. And he fouls this one off. Another full count pitch home. And it's fouled away. Payoff pitch one more time. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. Fouled away.
Hey, five foul balls in a row. Loving the battle in the box right here, making the pitcher work.
And he finally puts him away here as he strikes him out after an 11-pitch at bat. Next, it'll be Brandon Nimmo.
Nimmo.
And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. So here's Francisco Lindor now. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Ball and two strikes. The count now with the bases empty and two away.
Going to be a long day if he executes.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Second inning set to go, and next to hit is the catcher, Omar Narvaez. On the ground, a second for Baez. Right to him. Throw is in time for the first out of the second. So one out and nobody aboard, and that'll bring up Eduardo Escobar. No score here as we play inning number two. Two and one.
Ball.
He's fallen behind now. 3-1. Daniel Vogelback is on deck. And the count will be full. High and deep to straightaway right. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Daniel Vogelback's next. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive.
Vogelback.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Bases are empty here with two men out. got him swinging, and that's the third out. Into the box, Pete Alonso, lifetime against this pitcher. He's gone 3 for 6. Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. Swung out and missed, and it's even at 2-2.
Hey guys, that fastball just registered 97 miles an hour on a night like tonight where it's super cold out. If you don't get to head to that baseball right there and you get jammed, it's almost like getting stung by a pack of wasps.
Even at 2 balls and 2 strikes, here's the pitch. Right side. Scooped up. And that's out number one. Now one down with the bases empty. And up next, the left-handed hitting Michael Conforto. The 1-1 home. Fastball that misses. Pulled toward right center field. Kane is under it. 2 down. Base is empty, 2 away. With it comes Javi Baez to the plate.
Baez.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. On that fastball is too much for him there. 1-2.
You know, on a cold night like this, I think you're going to see him continue to elevate.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Gone. He finds the short porch for a home run. To the plate now, Jeff McNeil. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. In his career against this pitcher, he's gone 2 for 5. 3-1 to the Mets left fielder. James McCann would be next. To right field and absolutely hammered. Forget about making a play on that ball. It's way out of here. Back-to-back home runs. Now James McCann. Good take there to lay off the high fastball.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots, and now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Batting none.
Now to the plate, the pitcher, Marcus Stroman.
Rover.
Set. Here comes the 1-1. Good change of speeds, but he lays off 2-1.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Here now the 2-2. Line hard deep into left. And he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends the inning. Leading off the inning, it'll be Lorenzo Cain as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
And he'll put this one away for the first out of the inning. And now, Brandon Woodruff. Grounded up the first baseline. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So now to the plate, Colton Wong. He went down on strikes in his last at bat. 2 out, nobody on. He loses him on ball 4. And now in the box, Willy Adames struck out in his first at bat. Now a throw over. And he has to dive, but he's back in easily. now the 1-1 pitch.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound.
That will have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. Bottom of the third now, and standing in is the veteran third baseman Jonathan Villar. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Drilled right back up the middle, and that finds its way through for a base hit. So with that, the Mets have a runner aboard to get the inning underway. Into the box now, Brandon Nimmo. No offer on that one, two balls and a strike.
Right back into a good hitter's count now after what was a pretty dreadful second inning. He's got to start throwing a lot more strikes. Quality strikes would help too.
Here's a look over to first, and he's back easily. The 2-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Ripped down the first base line. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And this will work as a sacrifice as they get the out at first, but the runner moves into scoring position at second base. And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Now the 2-1 pitch.
I can't tell you how big a pitch the last one was. The difference between 3-1 and 2-2. 2-2, you're probably taking a turn for the dugout.
That's in there, and it'll run the count to full 3-2. Fly ball to straightaway left. Yelich is under it. Two gone. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. So a man at second here with two away, and up steps the power bat of Pete Alonso. Now the 1-1 pitch. Villar at second with two down. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Fouled off. Once again, a 3-2. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Set for the start of the fourth, and coming forward, the veteran outfielder Christian Yelich. And he fouls this one off. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Again, a 1-2. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Here's another 1-2. And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout. And there's one away.
The right fielder, opposite.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Looking up is Nimmo. Out of here, into the visitor's bullpen. Stepping in now, Narvaez. High in the air out to center field. Waiting on it is Nimmo. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Two down, no one on base, and that'll bring up Eduardo Escobar. And the pitch on 2-1.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me.
Oh, and he hammers it to deep right field. And he's going to make the catch. Oh, and he paid the price for it, too, as he crashes into the wall. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Michael Conforto. Now the 1-1 pitch. A bouncer to the left side. And that's the first out. So one down, no one aboard. And into bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. So two are gone in the Mets' half of the fourth, and that'll bring in Jeff McNeil.
He turned around that fastball and drove it out of the park in his previous at bat, so there's got to be a good chance they mix it up right here on him and try and go off speed.
2-2 now, coming down in buckets. Cats and dogs, insert metaphor here, and the forecast is not showing any signs of relief.
Total agreement, Matt, in particular that pitcher's mound. You know, one of the things you have to really be careful, not just for the position players, but that mound gets awfully slippery and awfully wet when it becomes moist like it is right now. So the umpires are going to have to really pay attention to the conditions on the field.
There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. And it's fouled away.
Four foul balls in this AB. Pitcher cannot find anywhere to go to put this guy away.
Fouled away. That's lifted the other way out to left. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Ready to go in the top of the fifth. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Daniel Vogelbach. A little behind on that swing, and now they'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Here comes the 1-2. It's a sinker that misses for a ball. Chopped on the ground to first. A toss behind the back. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. So one gone in the Milwaukee fifth. And that'll bring up the center fielder, Lorenzo Cain. Skied into straightaway right. Conforto is there, two down. And now here is Brandon Woodruff. He bounced out last time up. The 3-1 pitch. He is in there for a full count now, 3-2. Left side, but well fouled. Sinker called strike three as he's rung up and the side is retired. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, James McCann. The 1-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two.
1-2.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Into the windup and the pitch. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. So here now is the pitcher, Marcus Stroman. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
1-2, here it comes. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
Now batting, third base.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Jonathan Villar, trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Two balls and two strikes to Jonathan Villar. High and deep down the left field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ball game, and that one ends the inning. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up Colton Wong. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hard hit ball to second. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Now to bat, Willie Adames. He's hoping to avoid the hat trick. Struck out in each of his first two plate appearances so far. Swung on and missed. 1-2 now.
1-2.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Into right field. That's a base hit.
Now down. Left field.
Into the box, Christian Yelich.
That's
tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
And that'll get over the wall, so forget about sending the runner. It'll be second and third now with only one away. And it looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk. And the force play is now in order. 3-1 takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
You just can't do that in a game. You cannot swing at ball four with the bases loaded. I had one coach tell me, and I never forgot it, when the bases are loaded, take the pressure off yourself and just try and get the guy in from third.
Throws him on the breaking ball that time. Omar Narvaez sent packing for out number two in the sixth. He's got it. They'll go to Baez at second for the force, and that ends the inning. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Brandon Nimmo. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Number 31 takes the mound as he's been called upon to pitch. Now into the box, Francisco Lindor, 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Set, here's the 3-1. Out in front as this is pulled foul into the seats. Ball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Next will be the Mets cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso. He's grounded out and struck out in his two trips to the plate. Back up the middle. Wong is there. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Seth Lugo is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 67. Seth.
At the plate now is Daniel Vogelbach. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. 1-1.
Two balls, one strike.
fly ball out to straightaway center. Nimmo is there, and he has it for the first down. One away for the Brewers in their half of the seventh, and that'll bring up Lorenzo Cain. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Fastball at the knees, maybe even below the knees, but it's strike three called, and there are two away. Luis Urias will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. A 1-2. And that misses 2-2. In the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Daniel Norris gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 32, Daniel.
Last half of the seventh here, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Michael Conforto. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. After it is Kane. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Striding in is Javier Baez. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. A 1-2 pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. Now to the plate, Jeff McNeil. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. The 3-1. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner. McNeil, the runner at first with two gone.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
And a full count for James McCann. Three balls and two strikes.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Fouled off. Popped him up. Escobar shading to his right, and he makes the play to end the inning. Aaron Loop will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Jose Peraza will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hole in the order here on that double switch. Now the 1-1 pitch. Late square, and this is popped up. And he'll lunge forward to make the catch for the first out. So now into the box is Willy Adames. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat. The 1-1. Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time. Now to the plate, here is Christian Yelich, 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. That's a foul ball off to the left, and it moves to 1-2. The pitch. Oh, and they pull the string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight. Major
Strickland.
He's on the pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 43.
Ready now is Jose Peraza, and he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. The 1-1 is in there for strike number two.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Takes this the other way to right, and that's a base hit, so a chance for some important insurance here to kick off the bottom of the eighth.
Third baseman, number one, Jonathan.
At the plate, Jonathan Villar. Good slider there, but laid off and called the ball low.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
As a look, now the pitch. Inside as he nearly got him, and it's ball four. So it's first and second now. Nobody out. And ready to bat next, the Wyoming native, Brandon Nimmo. Got it back in time there, and it's 2-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Stays alive here as he gets a piece of this, and in turn he gets a piece of the catcher behind the plate. Another try at 2-2. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Brandon Nimmo is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning.
Going.
Now both runners are breaking. Off for that and missed. Here's the throw. Not in time. He's safe at third as they pull off the double steal. Peraza on third. Villar at second with one away. Count still at 1-2.
This is a situation where you're going strictly for the strikeout. Infield in, and from the offensive standpoint, you're just trying to create hard contact and get it by that infield.
And another foul ball. The next 1-2 pitch. And he fouls this one off. Here he comes again, 1-2.
Number three hole hitter up right now. Cleanup guy on deck. Two ball, two strike count. I think pitcher wants to make something happen right here.
He pulls this one into right, and that will get down as he delivers a big one here. It's a base hit, and the insurance run comes across to score from third. It's now 3-1.
The first baseman, Alonso.
At the plate now, Pete Alonso. Nearly got the inside, but ruled the ball.
Couldn't be a whole lot better situation to hit in now. 3-1, two on. He's got to be thinking he's going to get a pitch he can drive right here.
3-2 now. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. And it's fouled away. One more time, and he misses with it, ball four, so that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball. So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen. Michael Conforto will be the first to meet him here, and they'll do so in an enviable situation indeed. Bases loaded and only one out now. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Props to the hitter right there for laying off with a guy on third. You want to be aggressive, but you have to get a pitch you can drive.
The 2-2 one more time.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
And this is swung on and missed, a huge out there as the bases will stay loaded with two away now.
The second baseman, Javier
He sent the payoff pitch. Base hit, line drive into the corner. One run is scored. Now it's cut off. A throw to the plate. The tag, and he is out at the plate as two runs score, but not the third. So now to the plate, Abisail Garcia. Hit hard but foul. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Peraza comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first down. Next up is Narvaez. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. Ready with the 1-1.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well three times in a row with off speed.
The count is 2-2 to the Brewers catcher.
Two balls, two strikes.
Curveball, and he buckled him, but it's full 3-2. Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Eduardo Escobar standing in, and he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. 1-1. It's laid off for ball two.
Two balls, one strike, a count.
All even now, 2-2. Crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. The Brewers down to their final strike. And again, he's unable to keep it fair, but he's putting together quite a battle at the plate.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to
swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Well, in hindsight, it was the right choice to let the setup guy stay in the game and finish this thing. I wasn't so sure before, but the results sure speak for themselves.
Tonight's game comes to an end. 5-1, the final score. The Metropolitans crossed the plate three times in the eighth, helping propel them to the win. Marcus Stroman takes home the win. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.